Hello everyone! In this video, we'll learn how to record a video demonstration. This is the start page that appears when you launch ActivePresenter. Click Record Video. Then you'll see a blue rectangle indicating the capture area and the Recording Project dialog containing recording options. Any action that happens inside the rectangle will be recorded. To change the size and position of the capture area, drag it on the screen. You can also have a precise capture area size using the size box, or select one from the presets here. On the other hand, to record phone screen, click this button. To record an application that doesn't stay still during the recording, lock the blue rectangle to that application. You can let the target application fit into the rectangle or vice versa. Select the target F and the blue rectangle will stick to and follow it when it moves. Click this button to record webcam and you will see a webcam preview next to it. When you start to record, screen and webcam will be recorded simultaneously. Similarly, click the audio button to record audio. You can record both system audio and audio from microphone. Drag this scale to adjust the recording sound level. Furthermore, ActivePresenter provides you with some advanced options for the recording. You can access them by clicking the settings button. From this menu, you can select recording frame rates for specific purposes, detect optimal recording sensitivity levels. However, we will discuss them in the video, Advanced Recording Settings. Now click this button to show the recording toolbar. It displays some information about the recording project that may vary during the recording. You can see the current frame number of the project and how many frames are missed in the recorded video. Because you are recording video demonstrations, the mode will always be video. This section shows how long the recording project is. If you record audio on webcam, you will see the audio sound level and the webcam preview here, as long as you let them display from the settings menu. These three buttons are to pause, stop, and discard the recording. Similar to recording software simulations, you can press Ctrl and N to stop. Now I'll move this toolbar outside the capture area so that it won't be recorded. When you finish on the necessary settings, click Record to start. To group objects in Microsoft Word, select the objects, right-click them, and select Group. You can hold Ctrl while clicking to select multiple objects. When you're done with the recording, press Ctrl and N to stop. And you will have a video demo and a webcam video at the corner of it. When it comes to the webcam video, you should resize it so that it won't cover much information of the video demo. To group objects in Microsoft Word, select the objects, right-click them, and select Group. As you can see, all the actions on screen have been recorded trustfully in the video. In the timeline pane, object timebars are inserted separately, making it easy for you to edit them. Both recorded video and webcam video can be edited with powerful video editing tools in ActivePresenter. You can remove any redundant footage. To do that, select the video range that you want to delete, and click Cut Range. To have viewers follow the mouse movement better, the mouse cursor comes with click sound and effect. You can use the default or change them. To do that, select the video and go to the cursor effect section of the Properties pane. Make any changes you want for the cursor, and you will see the change in mouse cursor of the recorded video. More on editing mouse cursor will be saved for other videos. You can also add annotations such as shapes or text caption to give viewers more information. In addition, ActivePresenter provides you with many features that help you create professional video demos, namely closed caption, zoom and pan, spotlight, and so on. Finally, when the project is good to go, export it to video. You can export it to different types of video format. And here's the final output. So now you know how to record video demonstrations with ActivePresenter 7. Thank you for watching and see you later.